There we go. All right. Taking on Idaho at Idaho. Pretty sure we're going to win. I'm pretty sure we're going to win. I can't remember how badly we destroyed them last year, but we'll see. Oh and 2. Let's make that 0-3.
Glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA football.
Why does my TV do this? I don't know if I can turn this up and have this caught.
Innovation that excites anyone who thinks they can just
like it plays the audio, but like there's it's really staticky. It's really weird. And that's the thing, it could either be my cords or it could be my TV in and of itself. It could honestly be either one, because the TV's like 6 years old, and the cords are almost as old as well. I bought these HDMI cords on eBay. They were in a $3 to $5 sale. They were wrapped. They were wrapped up as if, you know, you were buying them, you know, from maybe like a wholesale place or something like that. But yeah, it was like $3 for $5, so I bought like 6 of them, thinking I'm never going to need 6 of them, or at least more than 6 of them. Usually get yours on monoprice. I may have to check that out, but see, now it's fine. The staticky is gone. It's really weird that happens for like, it happens for like 5 minutes or so, but then it'll eventually go away. Or it'll go away if I like pull the plug out of the TV and plug it back in. That's another way it happens. So if I'm in the middle of streaming, I just won't even care, because they'll like fuck everything up if I try to like dislodge a if I try to unplug a cord while I'm recording, my entire thing just goes apeshit. So I just don't do that. When I'm not recording, unplugging it and plugging it back in seems to help. Alright, this is going to make me feel like we're the shit. This is the game that makes me feel amazing. I feel sad for all the people in Idaho that don't come to these games. I mean, I understand, but I enjoy these games just because I love playing in this dome. Like, when I first got in NCAA Football 14, I did the Dynasty thing where you start off as a one-star team, and I started off with Idaho, and I like fell in love with playing in the Kibbe Dome just because it feels really nice. There's a few games coming out that I need to look into pre-ordering or buying or anything like that. Probably gonna get WWE 2K16 for my PC. That's when I'm gonna end up doing my universe mode. It may sound like a waste of like $45-$50 bucks, but my idea is that I'll probably do universe mode on the PC version of a game, and then I'll just continue doing it there until the newest PC version comes out. So that way I'm not like switching between PC and PS4, because I know with PC you can do a lot more modifications, so that may be what I go into there, is doing more mods and such. And just sticking with that.
Touchdown,
boom. Something else comes out March 11th. Oh, the new Hitman. That's right. I need to finish my streams of Hitman Absolution. It wasn't obscenely popular, at least not as popular as Crush Hour was, but I'm kind of assuming that it wasn't going to be as popular as Crush Hour was. Baylor fucking 3-0. What the fuck? But at least do that, and then I'll have the new version of Hitman to play as well. And then I think it's supposed to be like May? I think it's like May 17th, I think, is when the date is. Homefront The Revolution comes out. And I feel like I have to play that. I don't know how the multiplayer is going to work. The multiplayer is one of the big things I'm into. There seems to be a lot of things very similar to the original Homefront. So I'd really love to see the Homefront multiplayer work the same way as the original. I don't know if it will or not, but we'll see. But I feel like I kind of have to play that because I've been waiting on this game for like 3 years now. I've been waiting on the new Homefront for a while. And I think THQ made it, the first one, and they shut down. So, oh my god. Come on, O-line. Doesn't matter. Just get away from him. Not to mention, on this exact YouTube channel, the original Homefront was the very first gameplay I did. That was the first one, was Homefront. So that's why I also feel like I need to do Homefront The Revolution, considering it'll be a nice little contrast between when I first did, like, my first video. Like, I think it's probably been like 3 years now. And now, with the different home fronts.
You know they'd like to do something a little more than they did on their last drive when they had to punt the ball away.
I actually went and saw that original, like, very first home front video. Man, that, like, shitty font logo that I threw together in, like, I can't remember. I think it was like Microsoft Paint or something, but I managed to make it like a ping file somehow. Man. Damn it, come on. There we go.
Iowa State up 7 points. Scrambling around.
Oh my god. Okay, I need to get my shit together a little bit. Because I'm just kind of playing like an idiot. And I need to get my mind off of not being an idiot. I say this while I'm deciding a play on 4th and 12 to run. I'm very confident in my abilities to make this happen.
He's on the run.
There we go.
At about the 43-yard line. Unbelievable pass. They don't care what down it is.
Why are they giving the mascot 70s dances? Who animated that shit? Oh my god.
Right around the 44-yard line. That brings up second and 9. From their own 44-yard line. It's second down.
There we go.
He's all right.
All right. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, they got a hold of me. I think Willis is hurt. Yep. I'm waiting for, like, all the badass teams that, like, injure him to, like, injure him for the rest of the season. And it'll be, like, watch. It'll be, like, fucking Idaho that ends up being the guy that takes them out. That takes Willis out for like the entire season. Like, I'd seen some big hits by those big Oklahoma boys and the big Texas boys and the big Alabama boys. but it was when they played fucking Idaho. That's when the shit hit the fan. Why did my O-line suck so bad? Look at that. Wow, he missed a 33-yarder. It's all right. I figured as much.
Iowa State is up 7.
Really? We're getting that for like a third full stadium?
Now he's scrambling. Throws complete. He's got space to work.
That was my first thought, is, you know what, let's just, like, plow these guys over. Fuck it. Do we put in a rookie quarterback? My God, did we injure our second string guy, too? Did we injure Taylor as well? Oh, my God. Did we really? Taylor's out for 4 weeks with broken ribs. Willis is out for the game with an abdominal strain. We're down to our third string quarterback. Yippee-ki-yay. Let's do this. Hey, at least the freshman's going to get himself some time here. All right, let's see how the freshman does. Let's do it. Make it happen, freshman. I recruited you for a reason. Nice.
Around the 32-yard line. We've played one quarter. The Cyclones in front, 7-0. And we're back for more action here in quarter number 2. The Cyclones lose one of their key players. Injury earlier, still in the locker room. We don't know the severity.
We're down to our third string guy. I'm so glad we still tend to recruit decently good athletes for quarterback position. I also find it very lucky that we're playing such a crap team that would have a safety that would allow the ball to just bounce off his helmet without actually catching it. What? Wait a second. Oh, okay, okay. I was like, wait a minute, isn't someone supposed to cross across the middle? I'd seen the play on it. I was wondering.
Saw one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the action. Iowa State is up by a touchdown. He scrambled.
Oh, I thought I was going to be able to throw the needle there. I'm making a lot of really stupid plays. But if they end up working out, then I look like a genius.
They're going to try a long field goal here. Iowa State can make this a two-possession game.
I was trying to account for wind in a dome. I fucked up the flicking of that so hard. Wow. Today's just a fail-tastic day for some of these games. Alright.
There hasn't been too much
daylight. We're just... I hate to say this. I hate to sit here and say that we're just looking to escape Idaho with a win. It's like, God damn it. Have we fallen to this point now? Like, listen, I saw you guys play against Idaho. And I was going to join you guys. And I saw you guys struggle against a team like that. And I just thought, I don't think this is the place for me. I watch your offensive linemen just completely ignore the Alabama defensive linemen and your struggles in the Kibbe Dome solidified the fact that I don't want to join your team. This school's just not worth it. Oh. Sad. That's fine. In fact, you know what I'm going to do? Just to make sure. This is something I should have messed with, like, a while back. But, that's all right. there. There we go. Okay. Let's get that ball back. Oh my god. That's fine.
The offense comes out to start this drive, and they're hoping for a better
result. Let's see how well this works.
On their last possession.
And I don't think this defense will lay down lightly. They're going to try to continue to rattle this guy.
Ooh.
The 28-yard line.
Priority score alert. Texas A&M gets an even bigger lead. Oh, on LSU, who's ahead of them. Okay.
Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the 28-yard line.
Oh my god. Well, I seem to be like bowling them over, but I'm not exactly getting yards. Even though it says I'm averaging like 7.2, so let's see if I can't change that. Oh my god. My guy's a bit stupid.
Gets the first down there with a 5-yard carry.
Well, the important thing is they were able to pick up the first down, and they're really starting to show how much they're relying on this halfback to do all of the work. And right now, he's looking pretty good.
And there's boom, 2 minutes remaining.
There we go. Oh my god. This is when you know your offensive line is abysmal, when Idaho's defensive line is plowing through them. I'm sorry, what? Idaho's defensive line plowed through him? Yeah. Idaho was supposed to be just a throwaway game, but I was on suicide watch with my quarterback. It was a little sad.
It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. Royal.
Ooh. Ooh. I'm just going to do a no huddle so that way I still have a little bit of time on the clock to put some more plays up if this doesn't work.
He's scrambling.
Oh, that was bad. Yep, that's exactly why.
Much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions, especially when the
Come on, I can do this. I know how to play football. I can play football. I know how this game works. I know how this team works. There you go. Jesus Christ. Alright. There, that time we got the kick.
So an 8-play, 75-yard drive. And a touchdown as a result.
Alright, skip ahead, change the possession. Skip ahead, change the possession. Well, they didn't get far. Oh, it was halftime. Derp. Simmons, skip ahead. This is just embarrassing, guys. Come on. Idaho? Idaho. Idaho. That wasn't even a tackle. That was a drop toe hold. He just did a pro wrestling move on a football field. Is that not a penalty?
So it's second down now.
That was like a picture perfect drop toe hold. Come on. I saw it. See that? Ready? He comes at me, and instead of tackling me, he comes, takes me down. There you go. See? Right there. That's what a drop toe hold looks like. Boom, puts my leg up and over there, trips me up, boom, there you go, see that? That is a drop toe hold. That is not a tackle. That is a wrestling move. That should be a penalty. He did not just fall down. As you could tell, he moved and did that on purpose.
About 4 yards to pick up the first.
That being said, he'd make a great technician someday.
Try and scramble. Throws quick
wow.
To the receiver and it falls incomplete.
Was the intended receiver on the play? That'll bring up 34.
So it's all right.
And they're going to need about 4.
I'm just getting sick and tired of the fact that this shouldn't even be a close game. This should be just a slaughter. Wow, he didn't get the rhythm to turn upfield and get past the freaking first down plane. Come on. Come on now. We can do this. We know how to do this. We're not stupid. Boom, there you go. That works.
Really nice play by the receiver to make sure he had possession before trying to make even a bigger play. That's all you need to do in that scenario.
I want to know who does the
from their own 37-yard line. First down.
I want to imagine they got some intern hooked up to one of those movement capture suits to do these dances. Or they just threw some crazy guy like $20 and said, here, do a bunch of dances with this suit on. That's why EA charges so much, is because they actually don't spend a whole lot on everything else. What they spend on presentation, they don't spend on animations and such. Just give a crazy homeless guy a suit and $20 and tell him to dance for the motion capture. We need mascot movements. Get me Crazy Joe. You'll usually find him digging in the alleyway out back looking for food.
Surprised that they aren't going to just punt this ball away.
Come on. Oh my god, you're fucking fat ass. I watched Burke the whole time. Look at this. He tries to turn, but then he just doesn't get the acceleration moving. You see that? He lost like all his fucking speed. And I was going to get it to him, and I was thinking, he's going to get there, and then he didn't get there, and then I just ran out of choices. I'm like, well, shit, now I can't do anything else. I gotta either give it to him or get tackled. And I'm already fresh out of quarterbacks. There we go, come on. Ah! He still wasn't down, technically. Although I think in most football rules, if you're on the ground and you're connected to someone who's on the ground, I think that would be considered tackled. Otherwise, guys can just keep their feet on the ground somehow, or keep their knees from touching, and just use other people's bodies to stay up. I have to think there's probably some official rule that once you come in contact with someone's body who's on the ground, you're technically on the ground yourself.
He's on the run.
Heading for the corner. Oh my god. Dives forward. What is this? Why is Idaho's defense doing this to us? Why can't anybody get open? Get open.
It's second down and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
It's fine.
So at the end of three, 14 apiece.
We'll do this. Oh my god. He just pushed himself right in my way. And EA's hit detection being shitty decided to push me back. Ugh.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down.
What the fuck? What is this game? What is going on? Dude, I know it's probably stupid, but I'm going to make this happen. We are in this broken marriage, and I'm going to fix it. I'm going to make it work. How did he get in front like that? I want to see that. How did he do that? How did he get in front like that? What just happened? Hang on. I need to see that one again. Something feels kind of bullshitty about this. Enhance. I want to see this. That seems really weird that he was able to get in front like that. Just, I don't know. Something felt off about that.
They've given a pretty decent field position. Not a great.
I'm just not in a good mood. This game has not put me in a good mood. Look at that. 21-14. I have to work from behind in a game against Idaho. Yeah, this is not what I've been. Christ.
Heads up play there by the defender. Get those hands up and something good may just happen.
Hey Reagan, how's it going? I'm doing just swell.
Second down. Quarterback all by himself with five wide outs.
Get open. Get, I don't know why he threw like that. Superb effort by the fuck a duck.
This comes down to the timing between the quarterback and
these last few games have just gotten me salty. The fact that this isn't a blowout game is probably the single most irritating part about this entire thing.
Now he's scrambling. Catches it and he's looking for more. He's tackled. That's the 50. You feel bad to criticize anybody for being aggressive, but if he wouldn't have been on the play action, I don't know if they would have been able to pick up the first down.
Okay. Let's try to make this work.
It's first down.
We got this.
He's going to try and scramble. He's got to throw it in a hurry.
How is their defense like this? Jesus Christ. Okay. We're good. We're still good. It's still good. I have to convince myself of this, I think, more than anybody. That I totally still have this under control. This is still completely within the realm of my. Oh my God. Come on now.
He's taken down.
I don't think I've thrown to Rick Wade too much right now. I think this is a senior year. I remember seeing something about that.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and one.
So I'm gonna head off to class. Oh, that's fine. You know, I still do appreciate the fact that you watch on YouTube. Most people do. That's how I surpassed 1,500 subscribers on YouTube, even though I have, like, I think 79 followers here. let's see here. We'll do a halfback dive. We'll do run. Run play. Run play. There we go. Good enough. Good enough.
Not much there for the halfback. Picked up some tough yardage.
I don't care. It's good enough. Let's keep going. Is it really 5:15? Holy shit.
First down. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun.
Oh, yes, he got it. Oh, stay up. Damn it. Ryan Cochran. I think he's a new one. I don't remember seeing his name too much.
Play the drive.
I wonder if the gloves that he used to catch his fits. Huh? That is an obscure-ass joke. It's also a really... Oh! No way. What happened? No. No way this is happening right now. So this is my opportunity right here.
Right is the putter.
We had a touchdown going. I don't know what he did that made him fumble like that. Like, he, I don't know why he went and like tossed the ball like that either. But he didn't toss the ball. He like held on to it. Like, it wasn't an incomplete pass. It was a fumble. So I don't exactly know what happened per se that made that happen. So I'm not thrilled about it.
Let's see as they come out on the field what they'll do this time around.
Defense, I'm sure, will be aggressive again.
Oh my fucking god. Okay. Well, Ospreay's the newest member of Chaos and is challenging Kushida. Oh, yeah, I kind of forgot Will Ospreay's in New Japan.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 37.
Come on. Get there. Go, go, go. Get up, get up, get up, get up, get up. Bex Cross, come on. We got this. We got this. We're there. Oh my god, come on. Boom! Get there! Get up, get up, get up, get up, get up, get up, get up. Let's go. Let's go. Get the lead out of your ass. Let's go. Let's move it. Oh my god, come on. Line up. Line the fuck up. Line the fuck up. Oh my god, line up. Shit! No fucking... Oh my god.
Royals play today, I think, shows again why he is one of the best. Badly for him, they don't get the victory.
Boy, he puts on a huge performance and his team loses. I mean, hopefully he goes back and he talks to his teammates and tries to really help them get over this loss, because it's not about his own performance, it's about the team losing the game.
Fucking hate this game sometimes. I really do. Today is one of those days where I really fucking hate this game. There was so much bullshit going on. God damn it. I'm done with this game. That's it. Three games. There you go. Good enough. I'm done. I don't know. Maybe I'll come back to it in a little while. I think this happened once before where I didn't come back to this game in like 3 months. This may happen again where I just don't come back to this game until like June. Who knows? We'll see. Fuck. God damn it. How did it get to that point?